church service, and I'm sorry that you weren't there. Because I think you would have really loved it, actually, in all honesty. So I think you'll get it as we go through this. So Dave often goes to the early service. Do you usually go to the early service more? No, but you know.
The other Dave does, I think. No, I don't. I go to the late service.
Always?
Yep. Might be my evil twin.
No, because we had a conversation about this. You'll understand. You went to it at least once. Okay. All right.
I'll play along. Yes, I did go once.
Okay. That's the right answer. Okay. No, but you and I had a conversation about something related to the first service, something that happened in the first service. So in the first service, we had an adult baptism, and it was awesome. It was awesome. So I wanted to tell you a little bit about the story about that baptism. See, sometimes the stars just line up for you the way they're supposed to. And so you get that little nudge, and you go and talk to your friend whose wife has died recently, and it's perfect. He tells you the story of her death, and it's beautiful, and you get to hear that story. And then you get a little nudge, and the nudge tells you to email your friend because you're taking a new church, just so that he knows. And he emails back and says, I'm going to go check out that church that you're going to go.
The classic car guy.
Yes.
Got it.
And so he emails you back and says, well, I'm going to go check out that church in Cary. And he does. And he just keeps checking it out Sunday after Sunday. He just keeps coming. And then you get that little nudge to go to the grocery store. You thought it was for milk, but it was actually so that you can run into your friend in the parking lot. And you say to him, Mike, this car is so awesome. There are a bunch of guys at the church who are kind of gaga over it. You might want to lock it. Because you never know what might happen. They would love a ride. And he says to you, what do I need to do to get baptized? And then the stars kind of line up for you when you read the readings that are assigned for the day that you have agreed on for the baptism. And the first one is about Abram when he meets God again and when God gives him a new name and another promise to have a new son. And when Abraham found this out, he was 99 years old. His wife was 10 years younger. It was so ridiculous to him. He fell down on his face and couldn't stop laughing. And this is funny to you because when your friend told you that he wanted to get baptized at age 81, you wanted to fall down and laugh too, but not because it was so ridiculous. You wanted to fall down and laugh because you were so happy. That's how God had called him to be a part of this church. Some 15 years before Abraham got his name changed and fell down with laughter, God had come to him and said, you will be the father of a mess of descendants. God had taken him outside, shown him the night sky, all those stars. That's how many descendants you and Sarah will have, Abraham. Can you count them all? All those stars. But for as brightly as they burned, they never lined up. Because year after year, there were no children. Would God ever fulfill that promise? But when God makes a promise, God does keep a promise. And so, 15 years later, at the advanced ages of 90 and 100, Sarah and Abraham finally had that baby they had been waiting for literally all their lives. They had that baby and they named him Isaac, which means laughter. And you can imagine, Isaac was the most spoiled child in the world. by that point, right? I hope he grew up believing that God had hung the moon and the stars just for him. Because it was true. Just as it's true for us. God has hung the moon and the stars for us. God lines up those stars for us also. But there are times when it doesn't feel like it. There are times when we feel old at the end of our lives, 99 years old. Feel tired. We don't understand what's going on. We feel abandoned by God. The night sky is covered with clouds and we cannot see the stars. But God never stops making good on those promises that God makes for us at our baptisms, to mark us as God's children, to free us from our sin, and to give us new life, both now and after our deaths. And so we had a baptism at the service, an 81-year-old baptism at that service. It was pretty awesome. Mike came up with his cane, or a stick. He has this really cool stick, and he came up. I was going to go with the smaller shell. This is kind of how I like to do baptisms, is with shells. But, you know, if you wait 81 years, you get the big one. You get the big one. Yeah. And I reminded him that God keeps those promises. And so the next time you feel like maybe you're worn out and done, that those promises aren't coming true for you, listen to the nudges of the Holy Spirit. Follow where God is leading you. Fall down on the ground. Look up at the stars. And remember that you are always more